What's going on, Cubs fam? We are back for another Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes video, and my people, I have had an epiphany in this game that has helped me feel so much more excited about what is going on in Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes. And to talk about this epiphany, I've brought on my guild leader, my sensei, my Australian wisdom giver, the one and only Heinzie from ANZGC. What's going on, Heinzie?
How are you, brother? Cubs, it is awesome to be back with you again, my friend. Super, super psyched. And looking forward to having a good chat. Thanks for having me back.
Dude, yes. We do not do enough videos. And so everyone, please W in the chat for Heinzie just right now. Stop what you're doing. W in the chat. I need it. We need it down there. This dude's got ice running through his veins. He's amazing. So go sub to him too. He's got a YouTube channel and your Twitch affiliate now.
Yeah. Just hit the Twitch affiliate, which is awesome. So we're starting to do. Obviously, we're still doing the GACs on YouTube at the moment, but a lot of after party action. We're doing some after party action, some bits and pieces on Twitch. So super psyched about that, man. Pretty happy. Yeah,
you'll love to see it. So all of you guys that come to my Twitch streams and torture me with sending me one bit at a time, you can now go do that to Heinzie too. Just FYI. So anyway, I want to walk you through this. So here's the biggest discouragement, Heinzie, that I've been feeling in this game lately, and I think you and a lot of other people have probably felt as well, is this idea of you cannot farm anything you want to farm in this game because you have to farm Galactic Legends. And I realized recently that it took a massive, massive weight off of my shoulders to realize maybe I don't have to farm Galactic Legends. And I've got some footage here I'm going to roll. This is from Blade Baca. Let's play this right now. There's my game. We'll put this. Oh, that's Heinzie. There we go. There's the footage.
Jeez,
we're going to show big Heinzie here. This is Blade Baca. And if you guys want details on exactly how this team works, please go see It's Just Ian. He's made in-depth breakdowns on all these teams. I'm just going to roll the footage and talk about it generally. But he's getting Jedi to work very well against both Galactic Legends. And so, Heinzie, what if for those of us who are more free to play, not spending, and Galactic Legends are just so far gone, so far out of reach, what if we just farm the Galactic Legend or the Jedi? Gas is a bit of a stretch for a lot of people, but I've been able to get him now. What if you just do that and just farm other projects you like?
Absolutely. Let's start firstly is, as you can see, there are viable counters coming up against these Galactic Legends. It was only a matter of time before the very, very incredible smart people in the SWGoH universe out there obviously came up with you know, theory crafting counters. Now, with that being said, these characters, man, they are pretty mental. We know that.
Yeah.
They're pretty stupidly OP. They're stupidly fast. They hit like a truck, especially with ultimates. I mean, it is tough work, but it can be done. There's a heck of a lot more RNG involved, as we know. I personally actually beat one in my GAC only last week. I don't have one yet.
Won the match?
Yeah, won the match.
Stud! That's awesome.
So it can be done. It's certainly not easy, and you've got to have things going your way. But hey, let's be fair, man. GAC is always like that anyway. So
true.
Overall, it's certainly viable. But yeah, I think that if you're very, very close now to getting Galactic Legend Rey, then keep going with it. You know, or Kylo, keep going with it. That makes sense. If you're way off the pace, maybe, yeah, farm these other counters. Farm something that's fun, enjoyable, easy kits to play and farm. No Kairos required. That's got to be a good thing from time to time.
Yeah.
But it just makes a lot of sense, certainly. But if you're close, finish it off.
Yeah, and I would agree with that too, because obviously it's ideal to have the Galactic Legends. But to me, one of the best parts of this game is going after characters that you love. And so a great example here, I'll show right now in my game right now, I've decided to go for the Mandalorian. I saw this guy come to the game, and the real tilting point for me was I made that video with Mandalore Maw about how his Mando was disintegrating Darth Revan teams. And obviously, mine's going to be a far ways off from being able to do that for now because I'm not going to be able to buy his shards. But still, I just had so much. It was like this massive weight lifted off me where I was like, you know what? I'm going to work on my Jedi Revan team. I'm going to work on my Galactic Legends counter, and I'm going to farm some characters that I enjoy farming. The Mandalorian. This is a great Grand Arena investment for the long term anyway. Anything that could beat Darth Revan is going to be a great investment. And then you've got that fandom factor for the Mandalorian and whatever else is going to come, hopefully Baby Yoda. And I just got to say, it's like this weight lift off me, because if you look at my look at my journey guide, all right? You ready for this?
Bring it up, man.
Okay.
Let's have a look.
Kylo Ren, let's see where we're at here. Prereqs, 0 out of 13. Let's look at Rey. And that was the one that I had favorited, 0 out of 13. Like, that distance to travel is just insurmountable for me.
I'm just putting a note down. Okay, find a replacement for Cubs. Okay, no, I'm just kidding, man. I'm just kidding. It's a joke. No,
please do not take me seriously.
Look, just kidding. Look, I love my bounty hunters as well. I'm a huge fan. I have Django at Relic 7. I did it pretty early. I wailed out hard on him because I was in the position that I could. My boss is Relic 5. I really love bounty hunters.
Yeah.
Definitely going after Mando myself. I mean, geez, my guild's named Mando, so I better go after him. Otherwise,
it's only appropriate, right?
But that's just a given. But I'm going to go after him. But not only that, Grief looks fantastic, and he's a good fit as well. I know him as Mando Apollo Creed. I'm sorry, I'm old school. That's just me. But at the end of the day, farm what you want. Farm what you enjoy. Obviously, you're going to get caught against these Galactic Legends. Either you're just going to it's going to get to the point where you either farm these counters that are popping up, and there'll be more and more because there always is.
Yeah.
Or basically just, unfortunately, be resigned to the fact that if you come up against these guys from time to time, you're just going to struggle.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's kind of where my mindset is at, is can I enjoy this game without Galactic Legends? And I think it's a bit of a rework of mindset, because we've never had a farm this crazy before. And so when, like, Gas came out, it was this mindset of, oh, that sucks. You know, I'm not going to get this for a while, but it felt like I'll get there. I'll just farm it. But with Galactic Legends, it's just so much further that you really just have to consider, like, maybe I'm just not going to ever get them. Do you think it's okay? Do you think it's okay to just, as somebody playing this game, to just go, you know what? These two characters, I'm never going to have them, and I'm okay with that.
And some people are resigned to that. I mean, I speak to a lot of people in the community, just like you do. And a lot of people go, you know what? Nah, I'm done. I don't want to farm these guys. I want to do something different. I want to farm things I enjoy. I'm not going to waste a heck of a lot of resources. And we know they are a ridiculous amount of resources. In time, there was obviously talk, you know, ages ago of trying to relieve the gear grind, so to speak. It may get easier to get these guys down the track. Probably not.
Yeah, probably not.
Because, CG are great at giving stuff away these days, man. You know, it's all happening, right? I mean, we're getting, you know, packs on, you know, May the 4th, and, you know, they're
giving away a lot of packs, yeah.
Oh, huge amount of packs, man. Absolutely.
They're so generous.
Content. Yeah. Yeah. No one wants a new raid. You know, anyway, let's not talk about Mace. Anyway, let's move right along. But, at the end of the day, it's one of those things where I'm at the point, and I've been speaking to some guys. I've got a guy at the moment in our community who's farming, of all people, Hoth Rebel Scout and Hoth Rebel Soldier. The reason he's doing that, he's taking them to Relic 7. And you know why he's doing it? Because he can. And no one else has done it. So why the f*** not? It's as simple as that. That's how he feels about it. You've got to love that passion. Obviously, you've sort of got to commit to these guys and go for it, or decide, you know what? I'm not going to go for these guys. I'm going to work on some counters in case I come up against these guys. And really, you have to sort of pick your mindset on where you want to go with this.
I think that's a really good point. And what is that mindset? And I think here's something that it kind of pushed me to this breaking point where for the entire life cycle of this game, it has been better for me to go for whatever the meta is, because that's going to lead to the most enjoyment in the game, right?
But you're not alone.
And so now the question is, is going for Galactic Legends going to lead to more enjoyment in this game, or is going for Mandalorian characters and getting my Jedi beefed up as a counter going to lead to more enjoyment in this game? Will it lead to Grand Arena matchups where, you know, from time to time, there's just nothing I can do? Sure. I'm already running into matchups like that every once in a while where I'm just outmodded.
You've answered your own question before when you said, do I want to commit to these or am I excited about Mandos? Automatically, you've made your choice without even realizing it. You want to go for Mandos.
Yeah.
So go and do it. And that's the thing, because you're going to enjoy the game more. And that's something lately has been taken away from us as a community enormously. And it's quite sad that we are forced in most cases, obviously, if we want to be at the tip of the spear, so to speak, that we have to farm these guys. And if you're comfortable with that, and obviously financially, if you're capable of doing that, then by all means, go for your life. But
right,
it's only a matter of time before we're going to get someone like, for instance, we might even get like a Bounty Hunter Mando, Chuck Watt Tambor in there or something like that, and it's going to supercharge and rip these guys apart. We don't know yet. It's still so soon. There will be viable counters down the track with other characters coming out we don't even know about yet. So, if farm what you want, farm what you like, run with it, because we enjoyed the game a hell of a lot more as well before they came along.
100%. And I this will just come back to, how are you enjoying this game? If your mindset is, if you're a spender in this game and your mindset is got to have the best, got to have what's current, then this whole discussion might not do much for you. But for me, I don't know if you guys have noticed, but I've had a hard time enjoying the new stuff in this game. I've still been enjoying Grand Arena, but Galactic Legends just have done nothing for me. But when I flipped that switch in my mind the other day on my stream and said, I'm going to go for these Mandalorian characters, forget Galactic Legends, it felt so good. And really excited to go in my game and farm these characters. And something else that I really hope, and we can kind of close on this thought, is we've got a new game mode that Capital Games has teased.
Yes.
I really, really hope that this game mode finds a way to give value to our rosters from all aspects of them, not just the very tip of the spear of those rosters that Capital Games wants. And I'll give you an example. I've got this 3-star 2 Zeta gear 8 Mandalorian right now. And right now there's just nowhere I could use him. Right. Mm-hmm. I could try. I've got a video I might share with you guys later of a gear 8 Mando having some value. But that's in squad arena. Hopefully this game mode, Heinze, finds a way to give regular benefit to our full rosters. I think something this game has lost is being able to take a 3-star character and say, go farm him to gear 11. You can find a place to use him. And right now, that's just very hard to find nowadays.
Yeah, they're sitting on the bench. It's as simple as that. They're sitting on the bench.
Yeah.
We don't want them to sit on the bench. We want to play with our toys. It's a game. Last I knew, let's play with some toys.
We just want to play with our toys, don't we?
We do, absolutely. I've spoken to a lot of people about that, and a lot of other people have also mentioned it as well. We want to play. This is a collection game. You have characters. You are actively farming, making them stronger. And unless they're full power, they're useless. Let's be honest. They're of zero value. You're not going to put them on defense because they're soft and weaker against the attacking teams. You can't use them. What are you going to use them in? Galactic War? Well, that sucks. I did it the other day with Rose. The whole thing, I cleared it, I think, with Rose Tico cup for fun. And I chucked BB-8. Hermit Yoda. And cleared Galactic War with those three characters. I mean, that's a joke. It really is. So,
yeah, and what about, people who, even let's say people who spend a bit, a lot of people who are comfortable spending on this game aren't comfortable dropping $300 to take a marquee character to 7 stars day one, right? These guys just want to take them to 5 stars, take Mando to 5 stars, take him to, gear 11, and find a place to use them. The amount of distance you have to go with these new characters to make them usable is crazy in and of itself for new characters. And so finding value for those characters at lower gear tiers, lower star tiers, would be a huge win for this game. So here's to hoping, Heinze, here's to hoping whatever they're doing will allow that to happen, because I would just love to see it. And I think there's a lot of ways they could do that. I guess they've shot every idea I had down, but hopefully whatever they do will achieve it.
Yeah, we hate being negative about game development and the developers of the game and everything else. No one enjoys this. Let's be clear. No one enjoys being in that state of mind. We all want to enjoy this game. We want it to continue. We've been playing it for years. We've invested a load of money in it over a long time.
You like your swear button.
Time. Well, time is money. Even if you're free to play, you invested a crazy amount of time in this game. That's just as valuable. So we want things to obviously improve. We want things to be fun. We want things to be enjoyable. And we really want to know what the heck people are doing with this game, because we love it and we want it to grow and continue to fold it to roll along as good as it can be. We know it can be so much better.
Thank you. I want everyone to hear what he just said and go replay it, because that echoes exactly how I feel. I get people in a lot of videos lately telling me that I'm being too negative lately. And I feel like a lot of people are misunderstanding our negativity right now, because it's not that I'm trying to mercilessly rip on the game. I have to be genuine and authentic about how I feel about this game right now, though. And because I love the game so much and see some clear issues that are preventing me from enjoying it as much as I could be, I'm going to speak out and discuss what things I feel like could change to make this game a better place for me, but more importantly for you. And not you, Heinze. I don't care about you, but you watching it, while you're taking a poop. Or wherever you are right now.
Feelings mutual, man. Don't worry about that.
Yeah, feelings mutual.
Hey, quick one. I don't think you're negative. I think you're frustrated.
Thank you. And that's it. That's a better term than negative. I'm frustrated. Yep.
You're frustrated, but you're not alone. There are thousands of people feeling exactly like you are. You know why? Because we talk to them. Because we're on Discord. We're in our servers.
Yeah.
We've got our own communities. Everyone's saying the
same thing. And why are we all still here?
Because we love Star Wars, man.
We love Star Wars.
And you know what?
We love the game.
We left the game years ago if it wasn't for the community itself. This community is by far the best group of people that I've ever met, not even in person. They're just an incredible bunch of people, ridiculously clever and smart and fun and enjoyable. And if it wasn't for the community, man, we would have hit the delete button on this damn game a long time ago.
I could not have said it better myself, everyone. Again, Heinze, I told you this man's got ice in his veins, and he came in and dropped some hard logic on us at 2 a.m. Australia time. So, Heinze, I just got to thank you for coming on this video. I think we had a really great discussion. Here's to hoping that whenever the road ahead hits, that it is going to give us a ton of hope for this game, because we do need hope right now, and I think it's been hard to have it.
Give us some fun. It's not rocket science. Give us some fun. It's a game. It's not a job. It's a game, man.
Well,
give us some fun.
It's kind of a job for me.
Yeah, for you it is, but not everyone else. No.
All right, everyone. Thanks again for joining us for this video. I'm sure you guys have a lot of thoughts. Fill up the comment section below after you gave that W to Heinze so that we could hear from you guys. And Heinze and I will both be in the comments reading what you guys have to say about this subject. Drop a like on the video if you think that Heinze should dress up as Rose Tico one more time. And as always, my brothers, don't forget